Hello everyone, welcome to Chitkara. My name is Chef Deepak. Today we are going to learn something about force meat, which we use to make charcuterie products. So let's start.
Objective of this video would be to know what is force meat, different types of force meat and their uses in different charcuterie products. The first question which comes in our mind is, what is force meat? Force meat is the base for all charcuterie products. It can be described as an emulsion of meat and fat that is created by mixing meat and fat either by chopping, grinding or puring them together to create a smooth paste. The texture of the sausages is determined depending upon the method used. If the method meat is chopped, then the resulting sausage will be coarse in texture. The style is popular in many countries. Smooth texture sausages such as Frankfurters and Brutters are prepared by puring the meat and fat together. In charcuterie, force meat are not only limited to sausage making but are used in various types of product such as pâté, terrines, roulades, and glentines. The texture and type of charcuterie product depend on the type of force meat used to fill the casing. Also, the size of the grind of the force meat will be determined the finished texture of the sausages. Coarser grind will yield a product that will have a chunky and crumbly texture, whereas a smooth grind will have a smooth texture sausages. Now the second question which comes in our mind is what type of force meat we can use. So here I am explaining you four types of force meat. The first one is basic force meat. The second one is country style force meat. The third one is gratin style force meat. And the fourth one is mousseline style force meat. We will learn in detail about these force meat in this video. The first force meat which we have is basic force meat. This style of force meat is also known as a straight mix, as the meat and fat are grounded together from a coarser mixture to a smoother emulsified mix through progressive grinding. The mix is then allowed to rest for few hours and used accordingly. Preferably, the fat use should be fat back as it holds well even when the meat is grounded progressively. This kind of force meat is usually used for stuffing in pâté, terrine, galantines and sausages. Now we will talk about country style force meat. This type of force meat is of much coarser texture and is made of one or several types of offal. Such force meats can be hand chopped or grounded through a large perforated plate of meat mincer until emulsified. Sometimes chopped meat is also added to the emulsified mixture to give a country style look and appearance. Many a time mixture of such is used for holding the meat together. This type of force meat is used for preparing pâté, terrine and few large sausages. Now we will talk about gratin style force meat. This kind of force meat is usually used in terrines and pâté as an inlay or stuffing. The pieces of meat may be cured or marinated and browned or sautéed to give a characteristic brown color to the meat. The browning is also done to shrink the meat and it can easily be used as inlay. During the process of cooking, the force meat and meat will congeal together and thus no air pocket would be created. This type of force meat is used as an inlay for pâtés, terrines and glentines. Now we have mousseline style of force meat. This is one of the lightest and smoothest of all force meat and usually made with soft white meat such as veal, chicken and fish. The meat is emulsified with ice and fat and the result is a paste, which can also be enriched with egg and cream. This type of forcemeat is used as a filling for appetizers or as stuffing for fish and chicken supreme. Sometimes various types of mousseline are layered to create pâtés and terrines. This is all about forcemeat. If you have any doubt, you can comment in comment box or you can contact me at my mail ID. My mail ID is deepak.yadav@chitkara.edu.in. I hope you are learning something new in my videos. Keep learning, keep watching. Thank you so much.